I'm back. Welcome back. I am going to do try. Well, it's a new foundation for me, but I've heard about it before. It's the Clinique Beyond Perfecting Foundation and Concealer, and I believe this is an all-in-one. So we're gonna go with that. It says it is a foundation and concealer all-in-one for a natural beyond perfected look that lasts all day. Lightweight, moisturizing. Makeup covers thoroughly without clogging pores. Skin breathes comfortably. Color stays true, even through sweat and humidity. Due to the rich pigment level that enhances this flawless coverage, makeup shades may appear darker when first applied. Once blended completely and allowed to dry, Beyond Perfecting makeup will melt into your skin for a beyond perfected, flawless look. A little goes a long way. All right, we will see. I'm going to start off with my Smashbox primer water. Yeah, buddy. All right. Now I'm gonna I normally use is my number 7 Beautifully Matte makeup base. And you can get this at Target. That's where I got mine. Alright, what I have here, I just got a sample because I wasn't sure whether or not I wanted to buy it. So that's what I do a lot of times. If I'm not really sure, I'll just get a sample. Alright, and this is in color Amber. The woman that helped me get this color. I'm going to try it first, one side with my foundation brush. Matches a lot on my forehead. I think that's the part that gets the most sun. It doesn't smell like anything. It just smells like what a foundation normally smells like to me. No fragrance. I don't know about you guys, but to me it looks a little orangey. But it says it will do that at first, and then it sets, so we'll see. I kind of blend it down to my neck, down my chin. And that is with the foundation brush. Alright, I'm gonna put some on so I can use my beauty blender. And if you're wondering what the orange stuff is on my face, I used MAC Pure Orange color corrector for my dark circles, since I'm not going to use any concealer because it says this is concealer as well. So I just use a little bit of correcting to brighten up that area. Guys, it looks a little orangey to me. Well, we'll go with it. We'll see what it dries to. I feel like with my sponge, it was just a little bit less, not as heavy. So I'm just going to go over the other side where I put when I use my brush, foundation brush. I'm just going to go over that and just kind of smooth that all out so it looks the same, so it doesn't look as heavy. To me, I felt like with the, it goes on well with the brush, with my foundation brush, but I felt like it was more of a full coverage look, if I'm making sense. Where my sponge gives me that very light look. Or a very, yeah, light to medium. And with the brush, it was like medium to full, I guess you can say that. Alright. Okay, we're going to let that set. And I'm going to work. Ooh. I'm going to work on my eyebrows. I don't know. Does it look a little orangey to you? It says once it dries, it will dry and melt into your skin. So that's what I'm going to let it do. I'm going to work on my eyebrows while I'm waiting for this to happen. I'm going to let it dry. That's what I'm going to do. Let it dry. Okay. Now I'm going to take, because to me I feel like it's a little too orangey for me. So I'm going to take a little bit of my Airspun. Translucent powder. And I'm going to pat that everywhere. To kind of set, especially the under eyes. Since I'm not using a concealer. Since this is a concealer all in one. And like I said, to me I feel like this is a little too orangey for me. Maybe this might tone it down. I don't know. We will see. And this is, I'm not using this as a, well, it's the setting, but not for color, just for setting itself. I've mentioned that before in another video where I use this powder to set only, and then I'll use my same skin color foundation to do the rest. Now normally when I try on foundations, I try not to do a setting or anything like that, but this is a little too orangey for me, so I am going with it as far as using a setting powder. I'm going to use my Pantone Universe from Sephora, and I'm going to use the gold color on my lids, the brighter of the two, the one closest to the end. Pointed at the wrong one. On my lids. I love this color for a summery, bronzy look. Need to sit up, stop slouching. Now, has anybody else tried this Clinique foundation? If you have, comment below and let me know how you like this. Because so far, I mean, it looks good now, a little bit better now that I have lightened it up with the translucent powder. And usually that's what I normally do to any foundation that I have. I will lighten it up with some translucent powder or mute some of that orangey-ness. Alright, Next, I am going to bring you a little closer. Next, I'm going to use the Marsala, the matte. That's right there in my crease. With a big fluffy brush, and this is one of the brushes that I got from eBay. I mentioned that in my eBay haul. And I got a set of 10, as a 10 piece set, and for $10, it's not bad. I like them. I know there's probably, I want to get, there's the set from Amazon that I want to get. I haven't quite decided if I'm going to or not since I got these. But you know, you can never have too many brushes, right? Alright. There's that. And with that same brush, I'm going to pick up the color Russet. Is it Russet? Russet. And I'm going to put that right on the outer V. And that's this color here, if I didn't show you. This color here. Use that on my outer V. Don't worry, it looks messy, but I will blend it in. Now I'm going to take a clean fluffy brush and I'm going to blend. And I have a pimple right there. I don't know if you can see it, but it's there. Alright, now I'm going to take that same clean fluffy brush that I had. I'm going to wipe it off a little bit because it might have got a little bit dirty from blending. And I'm going to take this vanilla champagne color or champagne color. And I'm going to use that on my brow bone. Now with that same flat brush that I use, this is my Real Techniques base shadow brush. I wipe it off. And I'm going to take the darker gold color that's right next to that lighter gold in that palette. And I'm going to add that to the outer right there. On both sides. Alright, now keep blending away. Alright, with that same Real Techniques brush, I just wiped it off. I'm going to take that color Russet, and I'm going to put that on my lash line. Bring it about 3/4 of the way across. Now, with that same flat brush, wipe it off, and I'm going to take that pretty gold, darker gold color that I put on last, which is right here. I'm going to put that on the inner corner. Darken that one, that side up. Just a tad. Alright. That's all I'm going to do with this palette. And I'm going to curl my lashes when I find my eyelash curlers. There they are. Curl to your desire. And I'm going to use today, well, I'm going to use the Unique, those 3D fiber lashes, or the fiber lashes, but I'm not going to use them on my bottom lashes, because I noticed when I did, a lot of the fibers were coming off, so what I'm going to do is just use them on the top only, and then I'll use my regular mascara on the bottom lashes. But I'll work with the top first. Well, I can work with this first. Let me do my bottom lashes. And the best way to do them, even though I said I didn't know a way, I found a way, is to look up into a mirror. And what I like to do first, I like to use... I'll use my Better Than Sex mascara on the top, or first coat. Can you see that? Alright, so look up into your mirror. That way you can get your lashes in. And I learned this from Jackie, or Game On Point, Jackie O. I'm not sure what she goes by these days, but she's so beautiful. She does the most beautiful, to me, flawless makeup. Every time I watch her, it's like her skin is gorgeous when she does her makeup. I love it. And it's like, I love her eyelashes. They're the best eyelashes ever. But I saw she, because I mentioned that I did not have technique for lower lashes, and I said, no wonder I'm getting it all over my skin, because I'm doing the exact same thing I do for my upper lashes that I do for my lowers, and that was the reason why, because it was dragging onto my skin. So you have to do the opposite, look up. Oh no, it's not the opposite, maybe it's the same thing. No, it is opposite because I look down to do my top lashes. While I'm confusing you, my first coat I did was my Better Than Sex mascara. And my second coat, I'm going to use my L'Oreal Voluminous in Carbon Black. My favorite mascara. Well, actually, my Miss Manga is my favorite, but I'm out of that, so... back to the oldie but goodie. Alright. That is done. Now to the fiber lashes. Oh. Okay. Now the gel or trans... what is this? Transplanting gel goes first, so I always tilt my head back as far as I can and look down. I look to one corner, other corner, alright, now for the fibers. If you didn't see what the fibers look like, or the other step two, it looks like little fiber hairs on this wand. I don't know if I mentioned that or if I mean, I'm quite sure you saw it, but I just didn't give you a up close look at the wand. Maybe that's what it was. All right. And it says to do one eye at a time. And that's what I'm doing. And I still managed to get it on my skin. What I hate the most. All right, back to the transplanting gel. I mean, you could do two coats of this if you want, but I'm going to leave it at one because I got those fibers everywhere. And if you're a person like me that likes to laugh all day long and you're squeezing your eyes like, yeah, like I do, then yeah, you're going to have problems. Let's get it closer. Look. Now, on to blush. Well, let me go ahead and set my face. I'm going to set it with True Match. I just bought this. It's the Now Truer Color by L'Oreal. It's the True Match Super Blendable Powder in C8. I believe that's a new color also. Maybe, I think it is because I don't think I've ever seen it before. All right. And I like to do the patting motion. Down my neck. I like that. Okay. Blend that out a little bit more. All right, I'm going to use my Pantone Universe Shimmering Marsala Cheek Trio. I'm gonna probably use all three colors. Start off with my cheeks. Give me some pretty cheeks. Going to use a e.l.f. brush, fluffy brush, and I'm going to take, wait a minute, let me go back and take some of that lighter peachy color, you can see it, yeah, there you go, in the middle here. I'm going to take that and put that just on the apples of my cheeks. Okay, and then I'm going to take that third color in that palette, is the shimmery color, and right there on the tops. Did I say the top on the other one? I meant I was going to put that on the apples of my cheek. And this, I love this color because I love when the sun hits it. When I'm on the side, bam. Mm-hmm. I'll put a little bit up here on my brow bone. I'm gonna take a clean brush from Sun Kashuk and blend that all in. Because I'm probably going to go back over it anyways. Alright, now, I'm going to take my, you can't have enough shimmer. I'm going to take my bronzing powder, shimmer bronzing powder by Model Co. that I got in my subscription last month on my BoxyCharm. And I'm going to put that all around the edges of my face where the sun would kiss it. Not really doing a contour of any sort. All right, now I'm going to take my take another brush that is like a buffing brush, and I'm going to take that same True Match powder and I'm going to buff it all into my skin. So I can look well put together and cute. Buff it all the way down to my chest. Some of that bronzy on my chest. Neck. And then for my lips, I'm going to use my Sephora Luster Matte Longwear Lip in Mulberry. I believe it's in. Can't really see it. I believe it is Mulberry. Still going to use my Sephora Luster Matte in this one in Mulberry. Oh, this one was in Deep Plum. This is Mulberry. That's what I'm gonna use today. See? Probably should have picked that one up to begin with. Alright. And I'm gonna spray, set my face with my, you know what? I didn't use my eyeliner. Because that's what I really wanted to use today. Sharpen it up. I'm gonna use my Scandalize Waterproof Kohl eyeliner in black on my waterline. And I'm gonna tight line also. All right, and this is my final look. Yeah, I'll probably come back and let you know how I feel about this foundation. As you know, I did feel like it was a little too orange. But once I started putting on the rest of my makeup, then it started to look a little bit more how I like my face to look, not like a Oompa Loompa on camera. But yeah, I will go the rest of the day, and it is now 1:23, and I'll check back in a couple hours and see how this goes. But you know, it may not be. Got plug stuff on my hands. It may not be a true review since I did have to use my powders on it to kind of tone it down. But as far as the way it feels on my skin, it is lightweight. It does feel lightweight. It does feel like, so far, it looks like it may control the oil, but since I did have to use my foundation, since I did have to use a setting powder, we'll see. Usually, even if I use a setting powder, I still get the oil breakthrough. So I will check back with you in a few hours and we'll see how this goes. All right, see you later. Bye. Hi, it's the end of the night and I've worn this foundation. I started, it was almost 1:30 and it's now 9:20 p.m. And I don't know, I guess I haven't had to blot or anything like that. So I left everything, I haven't done anything. I haven't blotted, I haven't used any sprays or anything after I did this. So this is just a little bit of shininess, but let's see. That's normal shininess, I would think. Normal around my nose. My forehead. And my chin. Just a normal T-zone that I always get. And I don't know if it would have made a difference whether I powdered or not, because I have oily skin, I just tend to powder anyway, so no matter what, I'm going to powder just to help keep the makeup on and staying fresh as long as I can without having to blot too many times during the day. But this, I do like this foundation. I think it's a little too orangey for my skin tone, but maybe if I used my Cover FX drops, maybe that would help tone that oranginess down. But overall, this is a good product. You can still see, I don't know, you can't see my blush anymore, but not really. And I really didn't do a whole lot today. My eyeshadow's still there, my eyebrows. And my lipstick stayed. I used the Sephora Sephora Luster Matte Longwear Lip Color, and this is in Deep Plum, I believe. So, and only where it weared away was just on the inside of my mouth where I ate, but that's gonna happen when you eat and you drink. And I had not reapplied it, so very beautiful color. But yeah, like I said, I mean, it got oily right around my nose and on my forehead and a little bit on my chin. And I mean, my blush is no longer on. So this is about, let's see, about eight hours of wear. So, I mean, you can't beat it. It's great. Like I said, a little too orangey for my likings, but you can always tone that down with some powder. So that's my Clinique Beyond Perfection foundation review, or I guess trial, whatever you want to call it. But yeah, that's my thoughts on that. It's a great product, and I probably If I do buy it, it will probably, I will probably mix it when my cover effects drops. But as of right now, I have to try it with the drops and see, because I don't want to spend, I mean, it's only $27, and I say only because some of the other foundations out there, they are a little bit higher in price. So I say $27, and I don't think that's a bad price for me, personally. But I don't know. I would probably try. I need to try it with my CoverFX drops, and then I will give you a further update on how it worked with the drops, whether I had to tone it down or not. But other than that, it was a great product. So thumbs up this video and subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in a later video. Bye.